gentlemen.
She's thinking about a perfect shade.
Oh no, we're just getting close.
Lord, oh Lord, let me down.
I'm giving you a warning.
To dream a dream upon the scar of her breast. And when the night it fades from darkness, we'll have found a piece of truth.
Are we ready? It's a go. All right, ladies and gentlemen. It is the Duncan Showroom. It is a Monday night, and we did have a huge little snowfall dump this morning. Huge little? How'd that work? Well, it was very, very large for a short period of time. Caused a lot of confusion. Made everyone just decide they're going to be homebodies. But nonetheless, we're here tonight to broadcast to you something that it's a rare experience. Sometimes, every so often, there's people from different countries who believe or play in the same style of music as each other, but their roots are from two different areas, but they still have cross-mingled because that music is sent back and forth all over the place. But when they actually get a chance to sit in the same room and play together, it creates a whole new neat little ambiance that just makes the music come alive, makes it jump. And they've been on a tour, these two, for the last little while. They've done some shows all over the island and some in the interior. But tonight they're here to end off their tour before Chris goes back to the wonderful Scotland. And things I want to mention to you. Those people who are watching tonight in the comforts of your home, we offer this up as a free service. But one of the things we do is we do our best to make you feel guilty about why you should donate. There is a little button down on our website. I mean, if you go looking, you'll be able to find it. If you really wanted to donate, you would find it. But it helps us keep on putting out such of the product that we do. Very high quality, very professional, except for me. Don't worry, I'm not telling you any jokes tonight. Okay, we're going to get on with this right away. But anyway, Nellie Quinn lives on the island. And I've heard her name bantied about quite a bit over the years. Great young fiddler. And Chris McDermott, well, I've just been introduced to him. Already I like him for his wit and his just the way he handles himself. The two of them during soundcheck was very impressive once again. Tonight, it's a treat. It's a musical treat. We're going to go on a little journey, kind of a Celtic journey. We're going to be joining two continents together. Ladies and gentlemen, let's get to the stage, please. Our evening's entertainment.
Good morning, afternoon, and evening, because I hear that we're all of the above. This is our first concert that we've ever streamed, so.
Mm-hmm. And first one in Duncan as well, so thanks for coming out.
It's a pleasure to be playing for you. I should more accurately describe tuning for you.
Tuning for you. Very important part of music. But it's great to be here in Duncan. This is the last of our BC stuff, heading up to Yellowknife next weekend. And like John said, then Chris goes home. So our last BC show at Duncan Showroom.
Okay, we're going to start off with a set that we call Humours of Poverty, and it's with a tune that I wrote called The Humours of Poverty, about times in Newcastle, harder times in Newcastle, when studying led to poor financial management, and the only answer was Guinness, which is both nourishing and entertaining. Thank you.
tune was the first one was one Chris wrote, and then we followed up with a combination of Scottish and Canadian tunes, which is very much what we do, a combination of the Scottish and Canadian folk, whether it be modern or traditional. But this next tune is a Danish waltz that we learned from a Danish fiddler called Christian Bugge, and he was on tour with his now wife named Jamie Fox. And it was Chris and myself with him, and also Chelsea Sleep, a West Coast fiddler. And we all sat in this kitchen on Salt Spring Island, and we learned this lovely Danish tune from him. It's called Ingla's Waltz. Tuning is very important. It's like aircraft maintenance. It takes time, but it's worth it. Thank you. first two tracks are on our brand new CD called Greenside Sessions, which is what we're on tour for, our first CD release tour, but our second Canadian tour. I met Chris back in Newcastle quite a few years ago, and when I saw him playing music in the pub, it was not on guitar, it was actually on fiddle. And he became fast one of my favorite fiddlers, and now I've since dragged him out on tour a few times. So I'm going to get Chris to come on fiddle for a couple of traddy tunes that we kind of played around with a little bit. Guitar stand's not working out too well for you, is it? Thanks very much. So on that note, I'm going to pass it over to Chris Meredith.
Great. Well, I'm from the Highlands of Scotland. I'm from a place called Drum the Drocket, which is alongside a huge fault line, which, of course, in BC, you guys are very familiar with fault lines as well. It's the San Juan fault line. That's the one. And so anyway, I first time I came to Canada, I wasn't quite familiar with the immigration process, like what to say at customs. So I had been celebrating the night before and hadn't really prepared anything, hadn't worked out where I wanted to go or how much money to take on that. And I managed to even pack wet clothes into my suitcase. And I arrived in Canada at customs. And of course, like the first few questions are, you know, how much money do you have? To which I had no clue what to answer. I had just a few pounds in my pocket. And the second question was, where are you staying? To which I also had no answer. And in fact, I had to ask for a recommendation from the customs officer, who kindly gave me a recommendation, and I went and stayed there. Well, recently I was doing a bit of research, and I found out that along that giant fault line of the two pieces of land which were pushed together, those two tectonic plates, there is a rock that was found on the north bank of Loch Ness, and that rock is indigenous to Canada, which means that I'm from Canada. So next time when I came, I came and I said, you know, look, I am actually from North America, so let me go straight through. So anyway, I'm going to play a couple of pieces from the Highlands. They were both written by a pal of mine called Mike Vass, and I hope you enjoy them. They're also, I recorded one of them on my album Sevens, which you can go to my website and buy either Sevens, or you can also buy a copy of mine and Nelly's album as well. Also, feel free to, if you like us, go and check out our Facebook page and like us there. And if you don't like us, then just like us ironically.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. I'd like to invite Nelly back up onto the stage.
How about a song? What do you guys, do you feel like singing tonight? Hopefully you'll join along.
I tell you what, I've become quite adept actually at writing songs on the spot.
Really?
Yeah. I can write a song with almost any name that you can think of.
What about Acacia?
Acacia? Really, that's the hardest you can think of.
Yeah, it is right now. Do you guys have a better one out there? Don't be shy.
Penelope.
Penelope.
Penelope. Oh, all right. I hadn't prepared one for Penelope.
Just all the other names out there. Everything wait. Except for Penelope.
Wait, I've got it. I've got it.
Okay.
You ready? Happy birthday to...
There's a little snail that goes into a car dealership. You know, the guy with the little house on its back? So he goes into the dealership and he says, I want a really, really, really fast car. And the man goes, okay, well, we have this, you know, very fast Mustang here. And the snail goes, great. I want it in blue, but I want it to have all S's along the side. And the man said, why do you want the S's along the side? And the snail said, well, when people see me driving really, really fast, they will say, see that S-car go.
Cute canned laughter.
It's quite cute. It's very family friendly.
That joke always makes me tune really quickly.
Yeah. And maybe hungry.
Okay, so we're gonna play a song that was written by a friend of ours called Johnny Kearney, who is an absolutely amazing songwriter from Newcastle. He's written many, many great songs, and he's also recorded many great albums. So give him a look up, and if you know you don't want to buy our version of it, then maybe get his.
Joke again. How about we also teach them the words and we can help get some help singing in the audience.
Well, that'd be good.
Yeah.
Do you guys want to sing?
We're forcing you into it. It's either that or another one of my jokes and nobody wants that.
Someone if for easy resting, if you're ever caught, if your boat's adrift, I could be your port. And don't you close your eyes, see and stand the test, suppose to your surprise. Than the rest. direct to each and every call, and keep your heart in true, 'cause yours will pull you through. Your boat's been built for easy sailing, but if the weather's poor, oh, I will pick you up, washed up on the shore. Suppose to your surprise, you're better than the rest. Listen to those three-faced fakers, 'cause they'll not understand. And if they shout me down, I'll be there to hold your hand. But most of all, don't doubt yourself, love, 'cause you do just as well, or better than the rest, as far as any.
I've been teaching the Northwest Territories quite a bit in the last year, and I was up there in January, and there's this really lovely young student named Alice Twa up there, and she writes some incredible tunes, and she put together for her parents for Christmas this album she made in a friend's basement, and this album was really special because it was all her own original tunes. And a friend of mine who was playing guitar on the album for her secretly showed it to me before I taught her the next day. And I really loved this waltz, and she called it Mom's Favorite Waltz. So I've started teaching it quite a bit in BC, and I'm going to be going up and seeing her this Saturday. We'll be teaching at the workshop where she'll be. So I'm really excited to play it for her and show her all the little videos I've been taking of the students that have been learning her beautiful waltz. I'm going to get Chris to join me on this tune, and two Shetland reels to follow it called Fair de Rum and Undoing at the Bow.
Just gonna change my plectrum actually. I've got a very special plectrum. It's called a blue chip, and I'm gonna see if I can find it.
Have you heard of a blue chip plectrum before, or pick? No.
Oh, really? That's surprising.
That's actually been the common theme, it sounds like, this tour.
Oh, blue chip plectrums are made in Canada. Yeah.
Canadian made.
And it's also the blue chip plectrum was the very first plectrum that I spent $50 on. Yeah, right. And now it's the first $50 plectrum I've lost.
Or the second one? Is it going to be the first one you've lost?
Oh, do you know what?
Is it mixed up with all your Canadian change? Just use a loonie. That's Canadian made too.
You're a loony. Okay, I'm gonna have to use my backup. Yeah.
this next set, the first tune I wrote is called Lost in Bulgaria. And it was when I was living back in the UK, I went with an old friend out to a wedding in Bulgaria, and we landed in Bulgaria at about 2 a.m. in the morning. And I didn't realize that being a Canadian citizen, you need to get a visa ahead of time.
It's a theme for us.
Yeah, and I did not. I should have looked into it, but I thought my passport would be enough. And when I landed, the border agency gentleman didn't understand why I didn't have the visa prepared, and I didn't know what he was saying too well. So he got really frustrated with me, and he just said finally, just go, go, go. And I got through, luckily. I guess I didn't look like too dangerous of a person. But we had our accommodation written out, and we got a rental car, and it was so late, but we figured, you know, it can't be far, and we'll just go and drive, and we'll see signs. We did not see signs. And we drove around for a couple hours, and finally we stopped in this little sort of pub cafe that was actually still open. And there was a few gentlemen having big cigars and coffees and some drinks. And I went in and I showed them the address. And I said, do you know where this is? And no idea where it was. And that was terrifying because they were locals. And if they didn't know where the location was, then how should we? So that was a bit scary. But we got in the car and we decided to drive around a little bit more. And while we were driving around, my friend said, Nelly, I don't mean to scare you, but there's a black SUV that's been following us for a little while. But it's okay. I'm going to try to lose them. So we ducked around some corners and back alleys, but they were still right behind us. So eventually he said, look, let's just stop and see what they want. And I said, no, like, let's lock the doors and let's keep looking. But no, my friend pulled over, and so did the SUV. And somebody got out, and they walked up to our car, and they tapped on the window, and it was a man from the cafe, and he said, follow me, I know exactly where you're staying. And he took us right to the place we were staying, and it was just such an amazing experience. And that was really my whole experience for being in Bulgaria, was just the people were so friendly. So we ate at his restaurant for the rest of our trip and had a great time. This is called Lost in Bulgaria, and then we're going to finish it up with a tune called Superfly, which is a Kevin O'Neill tune, and he's in a band called Treacherous Orchestra, which is an awesome band from Scotland.
So, and the moral to Nelly's story is always follow a stranger who claims that to know where you're staying.
At least it's safety in numbers, right? I wasn't alone. Give some credit there, right? No, yeah, don't do what I say. Or what I do.
Thank you.
guess. That last one was on the album, and so is this next one. These first two jigs I wrote, and the first one I wrote for my partner. We went out on a holiday to Point No Point, just past Souk. Has anybody been there? Yeah, okay. Such a beautiful spot, and we went to Jordan River, which is just so beautiful. Such a rugged part of the West Coast. Lots of surfers, all the big trees, and the waves crashing. And it was in the winter time too, so it was just so nice and so relaxing. And after living for 4 years in the UK and loving it so much, coming back home to the West Coast, it was very humbling, and I felt like I didn't have to leave again. So that's Point No Point. And then I wrote the next tune for an old fiddle teacher named Daniel Lapp. Don't know if anybody's heard of Daniel Lapp. He's an amazing musician living in Victoria. And his kids, the BCFO Fiddle Orchestra, were at our CD release concert, which was really special because I used to be in that fiddle group. So it felt very full circle at the start of the tour to have his group a part of that concert. So I wrote that tune for him a couple of years back when I was a feature performer at one of his festivals. And then we're going to finish it off with a Scottish tune called Shinaruda Kudami, and that is Gaelic for...
That is what I saw.
He has perfect Gaelic, totally fluent, so if you want to talk to him after the show, you can ask him all your questions.
Thank goodness this is an internet show.
You can ask him online too. No, you can't get out of it. Thanks very much. So while Chris has his fiddle up, maybe we'll play this tune that I learned from him at a pub in Newcastle called Jock Bruins. And it was one of the tunes when I first met Chris. I would always put my iPhone down to, or my recording device down to steal his tunes. And I would always be like, is it okay if I put the recording device down? And it was on the pub table, so beers are getting spilled, you know, quite ruckus. But I loved his tunes that he had. He always chose the best tunes. And this is one of them called Jock Bruins. It's a great Scottish pipe tune by Gordon Duncan. Thank you. Thanks very much. You guys on for another song?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, this is this is a song that was written by a guy called Jackson C. Clark. Most people don't really know who he is, but it was made popular by a band called Counting Crows. Do you know who they are? Yep, Canadian band. Great one at that as well. And Jackson C. Clark, he had a really unfortunate life. When he was young, he was in a fire in his school and was lucky to survive, but he was badly burned. And he got an insurance settlement for about $70,000. And with that money, he took himself over the water to England. And while he was there, he worked with some great artists like Paul Simon, played at Woodstock as well, I think, in that time. And but then his life started to take a bit of a bad turn, and he lost his first son, and then he struggled with mental health issues for the rest of his life, and so he wasn't really appreciated in his time. So this song really sort of conveys like the problems that he had, and hopefully he'll be appreciated in ours. Travel to England, baby, maybe to Spain. Wherever I have gone, wherever I've been and gone, wherever I have gone, the blues runs the game. Send out for a whiskey, baby, send out for a gin. Me and room service, honey. Service, mama, me and room service, oh, we're living a life of sin. When I'm not drinking, baby, you're on my mind. When I'm not sleeping, honey, when I'm not sleeping, mama.
Wake up older,
So much older, mama, wake up older, and I'll just stop all my trying. Catch a boat to Angie, maybe to Spain. Wherever life has gone, wherever I've been.
Canadian tune. There's been quite a bit of Scottish stuff. Got to even it out with some Canadian material, right? We're in Canada after all. So there's this fabulous fiddler called Andre Brunet, and I think he's in the States right now, but he's coming up to Qualcomm Beach next weekend, and I would totally be there to see him and hang out and learn some of his tunes if we weren't in Yellowknife. But if you can make it, go to Qualcomm Beach next weekend, so the weekend of the 4th and 5th. And he's doing some workshops, I believe, and a concert. And he's this amazing Quebecois fiddle player. I learned these two tunes off him years ago. The first tune is called Tooth Fairy Jig, and the second tune, I'm going to mess up the name, but it's called Real Adrossan, and it's on our new album as well. And he wrote Tooth Fairy Jig for his little boy, when he lost his first tooth. And Andre taught it to me about a year after he wrote it. His boy was quite young. And then I was hanging with him last year, and we played the tune, and he was like, oh, yep, my son's like 12 now, or he was so much older than I expected. I felt like Andre just taught me the tune, but it's amazing how time gets away from you. So it's not a new tune anymore. It's a little bit older now, but it's still a great tune. So two Quebecois tunes for you.
Thank you.
very much.
Maybe we should do MKs.
Yeah. This one is one that Chris wrote, and this actually finishes off our album, Greenside Sessions. And it was really fun recording Greenside Sessions with Chris. We did it just outside of Newcastle with a friend of ours named Ian Stevenson, who's a great guy. He's in a few bands, Baltic Crossing and Can. And we just sat in his room in his house, which he designates as a recording studio, and we just drank a whole bunch of tea. Coffee for Chris, and we just recorded 9 tracks in 3 days and had a blast doing it. We were just sitting down, but basically like this in the same room, and in between doing this with tea and coffee, we played some tunes, and Ian got it down, and then we have it here tonight, like our little baby that we have from that experience.
Well, actually, that's not our little baby. Remember, we have our guest as well.
Oh, we have a guest with us. Would you like to meet our guest?
He's a little bit shy.
Come on, you guys can be louder than that, Duncan. Little shy, can you coax him out?
You have to coax him out. You'll have to say, hi, Koo.
Hi, Koo. Oh, come on. Hi, Koo.
Here he is.
So he's our touring buddy.
Mascot, yeah. He's like, you know, he's everywhere. If you go on our Facebook page, basically every gig we do a little selfie with Koo somewhere in the audience.
It's true.
So yeah, look out for this guy.
Watch out for that guy. He has two little pointy horns, little Highland cow.
Just to make me feel at home.
Thank you. Thanks very much. How about one more? Are you guys good for one more? Yeah. Duncan's lively place, right? Wild Monday night in Duncan. We'll do one more for you. We do have both of our respective albums with us, Chris's full album, my EP, but then we have our brand new Greenside Sessions album, some posters, some stickers, and
we also have it available online on www.chrismeredithmusic.com.
That's true. And then we also have a mailing list as well. And you can find us on Facebook and our websites too.
And you can like us on the Facebook too.
You can like us. I don't think you can unlike us. Well, you could like us and then unlike us, but best just to like us, I suppose. So this tune I learned in Newcastle from Katrina McDonald. It's called The Oak Hill Song, and it's by Miranda Rutter. This is on our album, and then we're going to finish it up with Humours of Tulla in a different key signature than the regular 4/4 time. We're going to change it into 7 for you tonight.
Yeah, but do you know how a guitarist counts in 7? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
That's how it works. Ah,
that's exactly how it works.
I could have learned that just from without having to go to music school. Oh, that's great. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
That's it, yeah.
There you
and,
go.
And we'd like to dedicate this set to Duncan as well. My brother, Duncan.
Thank you so much for doing sound and having us play Duncan Showroom. It's been a total blast, and we hope to come back soon. Thanks, guys.
Yeah, thanks to Tim and John.
Yeah.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you. Thank you. Thanks very much. Thanks for having us.
Thanks very much, guys. And please check out Duncan Showrooms on the internet as well, and come down to this wonderful venue, because it's such a beautiful place and probably one of the most unique settings that we've ever done a gig. So thank you very much to you guys as well.